जी, सो वी वेर स्टडिंग अबाउट चैप्टर 4, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी वेरियस टॉपिक्स लाइक द वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मेथड्स इन दिस वीडियो. सो लेट्स सी द वेरियस मेथड्स ऑफ कॉन्ट्रासेप्शन. सो द फर्स्ट मेथड that used as contraception as the natural methods. Okay, so here no devices or no chemicals are taken, only naturally. Okay, couples are trying to avoid the pregnancy. Okay, so the first method is periodic abstinence. This is what actually avoiding the coitus in the fertile period. Fertile period means, I have already explained you, the fertilization takes place after ovulation, isn't it? After ovulation, the egg will be received or collected by the fallopian tube, and it will be, if it reaches to the where the ampullary isthmic region, and if at that time the sperms comes, then only fertilization takes place, and that will lead to pregnancy. So to avoid this, okay, what happens if the couple avoid or if they are not having coitus, okay, that is from around 10 to 17 days of the menstrual cycle, in that period only what is expected, ovulation is expected, isn't it? So around half of the menstrual cycle, ovulation takes place, I told. So 10 to 17 days of menstrual cycle, that is the what period where ovulation can happen, isn't it? So if the couple avoid the coitus during this period, okay, so that method is known as periodic abstinence. Okay, so but here also the chances of fertilization are very high, okay, because the ovulation and all the other things are controlled by the hormones, isn't it? So there can be any difference, and it can not be a safe method of contraception. Then second is the withdrawal or coitus interruptus method. Okay, so in this, the male partner is not allowing the semen to be deposited in the female's vagina. Okay, so that is what withdrawal or coitus interruptus. Okay, so this is also natural, this is also a natural method where the chances of fertilization can be high when compared to other methods of barrier methods or chemical methods. The chance of fertilization will be high. Okay, then third one is lactational amenorrhea. Okay, so this is based on the concept that during the breastfeeding period, okay, if the mother is feeding the baby fully, then during this period the chance of ovulation and the other phases of the cycle will not occur. Understood? So if intense lactation or intense breastfeeding is done by the mother, then what happened during this time, there won't be chance of what the menstrual cycle to continue. So this is also another natural method. So the natural methods that I discussed are periodic abstinence, okay, second is withdrawal or coitus interruptus, and third is lactational amenorrhea. Okay, so now we are going to study about the barrier methods. Okay, next method is the barrier method, where the actual meeting of ovum and sperms are prevented by this. Okay, so they prevent, this type of barriers prevent the entry of or the meeting of sperms and ovum. Okay, so this are available for both males and females. Condoms are they are barriers made up of thin rubber or latex sheath that are used to cover the sex organs of the male and female. Okay, so just before coitus, if they persons use this, the semen will not be getting entered into the female's reproductive tract, and this can prevent the contraception. Okay, so Nirodh is a popular brand of condom for males. And these condoms or these barrier methods are having some special advantages also. That is, they are used as contraceptive devices or methods, okay? And at the same time, they can prevent the occurrence of STDs like AIDS, okay? They prevent the STDs, okay? So these are what advantage. Then other advantages are, these condoms are easily disposable and can be used by the user itself, okay? So that they give privacy to the user. So these are the advantages of what barrier methods can be asked, okay? This was asked once. There are 3 points I told. These are helping to achieve contraception, and at the same time they protect the user from the STDs. Then they are user friendly and are easily disposable, okay? Then other barriers include what? Diaphragm, cervical caps, walls, etc. These are the type of barrier types of contraceptive devices that are used in the female reproductive tract, okay? So they prevent the entry of the sperms into the cervix and thereby prevent the pregnancy, okay? And they are reusable. Then along with this type of barrier devices, spermicidal creams. What do you mean by spermicidal? Pesticide means what? Which kills the pest, isn't it? Spermicidal means which kills the sperms. Spermicidal creams, jellies, foams, etc. are also used along with the barriers. This increases the contraceptive efficiency. Means this will increase the ability or capability of the barrier devices. Understood? So if the barrier devices are having what? Spermicidal creams, jellies, foams, etc. They increase the contraceptive efficiency. Okay, so this is what barrier method. So two methods I have discussed with you now. That is, first is natural methods and second is barrier method. And the other method is intrauterine devices, IUDs. So this short forms also you have to study compulsorily, because in exams they'll be asked as IUDs, okay? Or what, gift, SIFT, like this. In this form, short forms will be asked. So be very thorough with this short forms. Okay, so IUDs means what? Intrauterine devices. As the term suggests, this devices are placed inside the uterus through vagina by the experts like doctors or nurses. Okay, and this IUDs are available in different forms nowadays. So non-medicated IUDs are there, okay? Then copper releasing IUDs are there and the hormone releasing IUDs. So like this we can classify the IUDs into different forms. Non-medicated ones exam. Non-medicated means they are not having any other copper or any other hormones coated on them, okay? They are simply physically they prevent the fertilization. Understood? And you can see that the example for this non-medicated IUD is lips loop. Okay, lips loop is the example of what? Non-medicated IUDs. Okay, then copper releasing IUDs. Examples are, copper releasing means what? This IUDs, not only they are physically preventing the fertilization, they also produce or release copper, okay? This device, they release copper, and this examples for this are copper T, copper 7, multi-load 375, etc. Okay, and then another kind is what? The hormone releasing IUDs. Hormone releasing IUDs example is progestacert, okay, LNG20, etc. Understood? So these are examples for what? IUDs that releases hormones. What are the examples? Progestacert and LNG20.
okay? So this can be asked with examples. So IUDs, they increases the phagocytosis of sperms within the uterus, and the copper ions, especially copper releasing IUDs, they suppress the sperm motility and fertilizing capacity of the sperms. This also was asked once. Okay, this, that is IUDs with copper releasing or IUDs that releases copper releasing IUDs, how they achieve contraception? They increase the phagocytosis of sperms, and especially the copper ions released by this devices, they reduces the sperm motility. Okay, sperm motility, and they reduce the fertilizing capacity of sperms. Thus, 2 points where they are in the marking scheme. Okay, so you have to learn point by point. Okay, so IUDs that releases copper, that how they achieve contraception? By reducing the sperm motility and by reducing the fertilizing capacity of sperms. Okay, then the hormone releasing IUDs. Hormone releasing IUDs examples, what I told, progester, SERT and LNG20. Okay, they do some more things, that is they make the uterus unsuitable for implantation and the cervix hostile to the sperms. Okay, so the uterus, the cervix and all the reproductive tracts of the female should be ready for receiving the sperms. Otherwise, what will happen? The fertilization, and if fertilization occurs, then implantation will not be taking place. So this type of hormone releasing IUDs, what they do is they make the uterus unsuitable for implantation and the cervix hostile to the sperms. Okay, so IUDs are also a temporary method of contraception. Whenever the couples wants to have children, they can remove this and they can have the children. Okay, so this help to delay pregnancy or space the children. Okay, so this two methods, that is the barrier method and the IUDs, both of this are also temporary methods. Whenever the couple needs to stop it, they can have children. Okay, so that is the difference. With so IUDs, I told what are IUDs. These are devices that are inserted to the uterus, in the uterus, okay, through vagina by the experts. Okay, and this IUDs are divided, or there are different types of IUDs: non-medicated IUDs, okay, copper releasing IUDs and hormone releasing IUDs. And I told how they achieve the contraception. Okay, non-medicated ones, just by its presence they will not allow the sperms to meet. Okay, and copper releasing ones, they increase the phagocytosis and they suppress the sperm motility, and also by reducing the fertilizing capacity of sperms. Hormone releasing ones, how they achieve contraception? They make the uterus unsuitable for implantation, okay, and the cervix, okay, hostile to the sperms. Okay, these all are temporary methods of contraception. Okay, now we are going to study another type of contraception method, that is oral administration of hormones, like what, progesterones or progesterone estrogen combination. Understood? This kind of tablets, normally called as what, pills. This pills, there is some prescription for having this, that is they have to be taken within a period of 21 days, starting within the first 5 days of menstrual cycle. Okay, so after the menstrual cycle's first 5 to 7 days, okay, female has to start taking it for continuously for 21 days. Okay, then after a gap of 7 days, it has to be repeated again, okay, for another 21 days. Okay, then a gap of 7, in that way it has to be taken till that female decides to prevent the conception. Understood? So how they work then, actually they are hormonal what combinations, isn't it? Progesterone or progesterone estrogen combinations are given. So we have discussed all this, how this hormones are controlling the various events that lead to the menstrual cycle. So this will interfere the normal functioning of the menstrual cycle, and they inhibit the ovulation, then implantation, and also they alter the quality of the cervical mucus and prevent the entry, or prevent or retard, or they slow down the entry of the sperms. Okay, so in this way only the pills are what useful to achieve the what contraception. So pills contains what? Estrogen, progesterone, or estrogen progesterone combination. Understood? And they have to be taken for 21 days after 5 days of menstruation. Okay, then it has to be taken continuously for 21 days. Then after a gap of 7 days, again it has to be continued till the female wants to prevent the conception. Okay, so how they work, I told how it is. They prevent the ovulation and implantation, and they change the quality of the cervical mucus also. Okay, so that the sperm's entry will be prevented, or it will be their speed will be less. Okay, their entry will be retarded. Okay, this may have some side effects. So what females will prefer the pills which are having very less side effects. Okay, so we have discussed about Saheli, that is the contraceptive pill developed in India, isn't it? And it is a non-steroidal preparation, and it has to be taken only once in a week. Okay, and there is very less side effects and high contraceptive value. This was also asked. Okay, once what is Saheli, where it is developed, and what are the advantages of them? What are the advantages? They are non-steroidal preparations. Have you heard about steroid and non-steroidal hormones like this? Steroid medicines containing steroid substances, they will have what, lot of problems, like the person will attain weight, all this side effects may be there. So this is a kind of non-steroidal preparation, and I told how to take the contraceptive pills in other ways, isn't it? 21 days continuously it has to be taken. So here we need to take it only once in a week. Okay, and then other point is what, they are having very less side effects. Then fourth point is they are having high contraceptive value. Okay, so these are the advantages of what, Saheli. Okay, this was asked once. Okay, we have discussed about the oral pills, isn't it? They are taken orally. And next type is what, estrogen or progesterone estrogen combination. Progesterone or estrogen progesterone combination can be used by the females as injections or implants. Okay, so this implants or injections, they are given under the skin, and they also, their method of action is just similar to the pills only. Okay, so the advantage of this implants or injections are, their mode of action is just similar to the pills, but their effective period will be more. Okay, they can stay there and act for longer time. Okay, then if the progesterone or progesterone estrogen combinations or IUDs within 72 hours of mating or coitus, that can prevent the fertilization and pregnancy due to any rape or casual unprotected intercourse. okay, so if the female doesn't want to have the pregnancy, then what? Administration of progesterone or progesterone estrogen combinations, okay, within 72 hours of coitus. Because why? It will prevent the implantation, okay, by changing the endometrium's arrangement and all. So in that way they can prevent the pregnancy, okay. So these are what the IUDs and oral administration of what the various hormones, like what? Progesterone or progesterone estrogen combinations, orally or as implants under the skin or in the form of injections under the skin. Okay, then the last method is surgical method that we need to study in this chapter, about the contraception. Okay, this is also known as what? Sterilization method. And this is a kind of permanent contraception. Okay, so this here the surgical intervention means by surgery the gamete transport is blocked. Okay, transport of sperms will be blocked by this method. Okay, and the sterilization that is done in the male is called vasectomy. Okay, do you remember vas deferens? In the vas deferens of the male reproductive system, a small cut will be done. Okay, and this cut will be then, this cut end will be joined. So what happens? The sperms will not be released, okay, through the genital organs. Okay, so this is known as what? Vasectomy. Vas deferens is a part of what? Male reproductive system. And the surgery that is taking place in the males is known as what? Vasectomy. Okay, and in tubectomy what happens? A small part of the fallopian tube, do you remember this? Fallopian tube is the part of female reproductive system. So in this way, there what? In the fallopian tube a small cut can be made, and then later this cut ends will be joined, or they will be tied, so that what? The ovum will not be going to the what region? To the ampullary isthmic region. Okay, so that no fertilization will take place and the sperms also will not reach to the fallopian tube. Understood? So in that way it can prevent what? The the fertilization. Understood? So this is what the surgical method to prevent the pregnancy in male is called vasectomy, and that of female is called tubectomy. Okay, so don't get confused. Vasectomy means in males. Remember about the vas deferens is a part of male reproductive system, and vasectomy means that is done in males. Okay, tubectomy means the cutting and joining of the cut ends or tying of the cut ends of the what? Fallopian tube. That's what the name tubectomy is given. Okay, then so the advantage of this surgical method, it's a permanent method and its reversibility is very poor. Means once this is done, the couple or the person who is undergone this will be permanently sterile. Okay, and very rarely only its reversibility, or it can be that person can be made to fertile, only that chance is only very less. So this is the disadvantage. Okay, so I have discussed you about various methods of contraception, like what? Natural methods, isn't it? Barrier methods, then what? IUDs, oral pills, then what? The implants or injections under the skin, then surgical methods. All these methods are not very much needed for maintaining the reproductive health, isn't it? It is actually something that is done against the nature to reduce the population explosion, or to reduce the number of members in a family. So if that is used continuously, that can cause certain ill effects like nausea, abdominal pain, breakthrough bleeding, okay, then what? Irregular menstruation, bleeding, breast cancer, all this may be the side effects of this contraceptive methods. Always it is not that it is compulsory that a person should get it, but there may be what this may be also a reason for all this. Okay, so what about this contraception methods and the importance of this, you would have understood, I hope. Thank you.